Melrose Member Independence Day. I was working in the Ministry of Works and we had a party in Woodbrook. And that night in the party, a lot of music was playing. And I turned and I told the fellow organizing the music, I said that I've been here but an hour and I haven't heard a calypso. Could you put in a calypso? And when he put on the calypso, some girls in the audience started to strip. And the men followed suit. I will never ever forget that night. And he had to take it off and put back the pop. I left soon afterwards with my sister and taking a home, I had to come to Port of Spain. There was no monument in the square, absolutely none, and that's about 12:45. There was no monument on the streets. There were no steel bands beating on the roads. There was no chanting or praying taking any place. Except here and there you might see something of a party. I knew then that we were paying credence to something that was given to us by the Queen of England. And as we had not fought for it, we could not celebrate it. And up to this day, since 1962 to now, and you can judge me by what you are going to experience, unless the government inspires something, there will be no celebration. Unless they give some holidays and give Steve Bank the right to come into town, there will be no music. And the children will not jump for joy because they know not what is taking place. Williams and Catherine agreed to independence. They did not fight for it. And just as they did not fight for it, we cannot seem to appreciate it. That's the big problem. Cuba understands independence because they shed blood for it. Venezuela, Bolivia, even America, all three countries of the world, China, whatever you think it is, you think of the whole of independence in India, they have thousands died. You can appreciate that because their mothers and fathers died for it. Julian Zabingo, we did. We didn't know when William and Capigu left. We didn't know when they returned. Somewhere in the meeting we told that we got independence.